Now for the headline story. There has been a leak of Intel's upcoming Raptor Lake 13th generation Core i9-13900K. Now, with all leaks, take the entire shaker of salt with it, throw it over your left shoulder, and hopefully don't hit some guy named Seabass. But according to a Geekbench benchmark score, the i9-13900K was spotted running at an all-core turbo frequency of 5.5 gigahertz and as fast as 5.7 gigahertz in single-core portions of the test. That is quite the boost from the 5.2 that we are seeing with Ice Lake at the moment. The even more impressive, 13900K rolls right off the tongue. I'm surprised they are going with 13. I'd assume they skipped it and go to 14.
I'm telling you, I was hoping they'd go to one.
Just
start
to one.
Right over.
Yeah. Just go back to Pentium. It's all about the Pentiums.
Yeah, yeah.
Perhaps even more impressive than the clock speed, which we're finally getting the promised clock speed from the early 2000s, will be at 8 gigahertz in no time. Yeah. are the benchmark scores. Now, it was unconfirmed what the core count was going to be for the 13900K. This chip is clocking in at 24 cores and 32 threads. So again, we are seeing 16 cores, or sorry. No, what would this core count be? No, 24 cores. Okay. So it'd be 16 cores. Gosh, I'm drawing a blank tonight. Would this still be 16 cores and then 8 efficiency? No, because it'd be 16 cores, 16 by 32, but then 8 of it. I don't know. Apparently, eight of these are efficiency cores and don't have hyper-threading, but that doesn't quite make sense because it'd be... Oh, eight performance, 16 efficiency. But that doesn't make sense. They're going backwards from 12 cores and 16 cores. I don't know.
I don't know. Everybody's...
I mean, maybe 8 by 8. Okay. Now, Sam's Tech, they wouldn't do 16 core, 24 thread, plus 8 efficiency. It would be... Here's the problem. If you have 16 performance cores, the performance cores have been hyper-threaded. 16 times 2 is 32. So now we're... The efficiency cores still count as threads. So if that was the case, if this was a 16-core performance core chip, this would be a 24-core 40-thread if it had 8 efficiency cores. So... 16 or 8 performance, 16 efficiency. You know, honestly, at 10 nanometer, that might be somewhat believable.
Somebody says it's confirmed.
Confirmed?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know how they could confirm it. I haven't received white papers yet. I haven't been briefed yet. So,
that's coming up.
Right. Hopefully. Anyway, what is astoundingly awesome is the benchmarks. Now, again, take this with all the salt you can muster. The single-threaded score on Geekbench was a 2133 versus a 1987 on a 12900K versus a 1686 on a 5950X. I will say these scores are not quite telling the whole story, because as we've seen, especially in gameplay, the 5950X and the 12900K pretty much trade blows depending on which instruction set the chip uses and the game prefers. So I don't think there's certainly not a 20% disparity between these two chips when it comes to single-threaded performance. So take this gain with a grain of salt, but in apples-to-apples comparisons, for single threaded performance, we're seeing a 7.5% increase from a 1987 to a 2133. We are seeing the multi-threaded score, however, stay pretty much flat against the 5950X with the purported performance versus efficiency cores. So 12 core, 24 thread plus 4 efficiency, but the efficiencies are not hyper threaded. Nah. Yeah, it's weird. It's a weird setup. Yeah, if it was 16 performance cores, the fridge wouldn't include a fridge to put it in. Linus actually tested that. You can't do that. SMT times 4 instead of times 2. I haven't heard any rumblings about four-way hyper-threading coming from any. Yeah, it's got to be 8 performance and 16 efficiency. Yeah. So we'll see. But anyway, yeah, single-threaded frequencies up to 5.7 gigahertz out of the box. 12 performance, 8 efficiency. That there's a problem there too. It would be 12 core, 24 thread if you're talking the performance cores, but then 20 core, 32 thread. So you're still off. Can't refrigerate a 13900K. You could if you had an insulated water ball for pouring LN2 from LTTstore.com. I hate you all.
Maybe a nice pint glass from not LTT.store would do it.
That sounds way more reasonable.
I think they got those.
Yep. They look fantastic too. Have this fantastic logo on them. Looks a lot like the Moonlight Ad Computer logo.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true. But instead of a plus sign.
But with a glass about this.
Yeah. Instead of a plus sign, it has a glass. Topical references for you and I and anybody who watched today's video.
Yep. Yeah, no, the only numbers that people are throwing out here are the 8 performance cores and 16 efficiency to get 24 and 32. That's the only metric that I've seen so far that makes sense.